So there's been an Illustrator update which has AI in AI. Hi and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to take a look at Illustrator version 27.6.1 with its new artificial intelligence powered functionality. And this video covers just the AI functionality. So let's get started. There are two AI-powered functions in this new version, and one of them is recolor artwork. So it works like you are used to. So you select the artwork and then click on the pizza, and then we've got the recolor artwork panel. The AI is just in this simplified panel. So what you have to do is go to Recolor Artwork Beta, and then what you can do is type your prompt in here. So in this, we want to have a space mission in deep space, maybe Milky Way, and let's see what it does. So let's click on generate. And once you do that for the first time, then you can open, or you need to open, the user guidelines. And then, of course, you check out what you have to do. And there are several rules, like so. You read through them and then you click on agree. So. And then you can use the functionality. And then it generates a couple of versions. And you might have already seen that in Adobe Firefly. Now, the benefit of this being built into Illustrator directly is that it can be used on CMYK images, which was not possible on the website Firefly, because there you had to upload SVG images, which can only be in RGB. So in here, you can also use CMYK images. And then you can take a look at these, and there are the three dots where you can also give feedback if this is a good or bad result, and you can also delete it, but that has no consequences on what you create in here. And when you click on it, it gets applied to your image. You can also check out the pre-made versions here, maybe you like them, and then it gets generated. And you see there are some variations, and you see also the prompt. You can go on and refine it with some of your own prompts. And click on generate and see what it does. And then you can find your way to different colors that you might like with your image. We can go to the sample prompts again and try out different ones and try out variations of these. Now, there's a downside to this, and this is about the language. So this is currently only available in English, so it's also only built into the English language versions. And if you have a different language, then this is not present in your Illustrator version. Once you have decided on one of these, then you can go to the advanced options and further refine it. You can also click on the colors and select some colors you want to have in it. So let's select some colors that we want to use and generate again, and get some results, and maybe we want this, and then go to the advanced options. This is the panel you already know, but you see the AI-powered recolor artwork is not built into this. So if you have checked this option here that opens the advanced recolor artwork panel immediately, then you don't have access to the generative AI. So let's cancel this here. And let's take a look at another AI-powered functionality, which is about text. So in this file, I have some texts that are outlined. And some of them are even converted to pixels. So when you want to find out which font it is, it might get difficult. You have to use different websites, and it's not possible directly into Illustrator, but now it's built into it. So what you can do is select even several of them and then go to type and retype beta like this. And you see, well, these all have different resolution and this doesn't work well. So let's go to exit and select them one by one. So I'm going to select them one by one and go to enter retype again. And you see, Illustrator can see which font this is. Okay, let's assume you want to apply that font to a different text. So then you go to exit and you see the font is still there. So these are all the fonts that Illustrator found out. And then you can select your text and click on these to apply them. And you see, this is obviously not downloaded, but this is, so I can immediately try it out. But also you could, of course, download these fonts. Let's take a look at another one. And this has been rasterized. So let's enter retype again. And there you see, we can check them out one by one and Illustrator finds the fonts in them. And again, we've got the list here. So in case it's somewhat dubious, then Illustrator lets you choose. Let's exit this and check out this one, which is also an Adobe font. Important to note, this is currently only limited to Adobe fonts. So let's enter. And here you see it finds different ones. So this is the correct one, but it also finds this one. So let's exit here and select the text. And there we could apply it. But of course, we need to first activate it and then it can be applied. Like so. And again, you can give feedback to it so it can be improved because this is just a beta currently. So there you have them, the new AI-powered functions in Adobe Illustrator.